How's it going, guys? Bringing you another video and an announcement, and I'm bringing you a video of a game called Mini Zombies. It's pretty much a third-person shooter. Everything is square, pretty much, and I show you some of the settings real fast. Pretty basic settings, or it's like Call of Mini Zombies. That's what it's called. Now, this isn't an iPod Touch Game of the Week. This is a new segment I will be doing called Game Day, iPod Touch Game Day, which is pretty much where I'm gonna be going through games during the day, any day of the week. And I'll show you here the armory. It lets you upgrade your equipment that you have at the moment and buy new weapons and equipment. I don't know if there's anything else other than weapons that you can buy, because I know you can upgrade armor. But other than that, I don't really know. But it's gonna be called. It's really late right now, so sorry about being really quiet. But it's gonna be called iPod. You can upgrade weapons too, and for a certain money. And each time you kill a zombie, and you get extra money during that. Anyway, I'm still gonna be doing my iPod Touch Game of the Week. But here's the thing: iPod Touch Game of the Week is gonna be reserved for different games, like more extensive and like long games that take me a long time to edit and that are better, pretty much, because those do take longer than if I did them on my camera. Now these I want to be able to get out to you guys sooner, because it might take me up to 2 weeks before I get out a iPod Touch Game of the Week, because of how my time restraint is and everything. And these games here aren't really that hard to edit, because they're pretty much straightforward. I just show you some of the things and then the levels. But when you get games into like Dungeon Hunter and things, I want to show you guys like dungeon, like certain bosses and abilities. But I have to play through certain characters and everything to do that first, meaning I have to play the games more and I have to record more and edit more, because the video is going to only be 15 minutes long. Here I pretty much just sat down and played while I was recording. And sorry about the lag. For this reason, this game likes to lag more than most games I've tried with my video recorder. It's not the actual game. The frame rate on this game is pretty good. It does drop a little bit sometimes. It's probably why this game is like this on the recorder, but it's nowhere near as bad as the actual video. And pretty much is it the third person zombie shooter. It's pretty fun. It has about 6 levels, and zombies attack certain levels, and as you try to survive a certain amount of days. I don't know how many days you survive, if it just goes until you die or what, because I haven't really played it too much. You have harder zombies like that guy. You have a chainsaw, and you start out with an MP5. There's no reloading, but there is ammo, and you can buy that in the store, and there are many different weapons you can buy. You have to unlock weapons after getting so far. You unlock them to buy them, and then you can upgrade the weapons that you choose. And see, there's other type of zombies like that guy there. He's like a jumping zombie. I think this is the first time I encounter him, so it's kind of, I get caught off kind of off guard there. And yeah, this game is pretty fun. The levels aren't like, you know, you go through like a survival game. It's just you pick levels, or I think there's 6. There's like a hospital, a house, a parking lot place, and then another parking lot, but it's like a complex parking lot where you have a two-story parking lot. But the other place I think is like a apartment parking lot place. I'm not really sure, because I've actually been to that one area. The rest I have. And then there's one more. I can't remember exactly what it is. You have your shop. So I think there's only 5 actually. And as the days go on, it does get harder. And then there's exploding ones like that guy. And there are drops. There are health drops, money drops, ammo drops. And I think that's about it. And then I don't know if they're coming up anytime soon. There are nurse zombies that spit vomit at you. And big zombies, which I'll show you one later. They're like big, huge juggernaut zombies that are really hard to kill. See, there's the nurses spitting vomit. And then they can, yeah. They're not very hard otherwise. I don't know if they can even hurt you close up, like hit you with their fists or whatever. The game's graphics are unique. I like the outlining detail on the walls. It feels really cartoonish and nice. As you can tell, you can see how they're all outlined. It doesn't feel like the graphics are really bad, though. even though they're not really the best. I don't know if you guys ever played the game Borderlands, but it actually kind of feels like that to me, the walls and stuff, and how everything is kind of outlined with a dark black. But this game isn't anywhere like near the graphics, and it's not anywhere near like any type of, it's not even close to the same type of game as Borderlands. It's just the graphics somewhat remind me of that game, and Fallout a little bit, but not quite as much Fallout, because Fallout is a little bit more realistic and more dead and not so vibrant colors and stuff, and this game isn't really vibrant, but it does have that kind of feel to it. But like I was saying before with the iPod Touch thing, because it does take me a shorter amount of time to make these games, because sometimes I'll have to take a few outtakes on certain games with the camera, or I mess up and then the camera dies or something. This here, you can easily just play through some of these easy games to do. See, I cleared a day. Or day clear, whatever, you know. And you unlock, after you get a certain amount of days, you unlock certain weapons you can buy. But like I was saying, there's four levels, my bad. There's a house. I don't know if you go to like a different place after a while or not, and there's more levels. But this is the parking lot place that I was telling you about with the two levels. And there are boxes at the beginning. And I have to play with the chainsaw a lot because I don't have that much bullets. And I will be going better to this, so I want to hurry up and finish this. I probably won't have this uploaded till tomorrow. I just wanted to get the commentary done because I probably won't do it that tomorrow very easily, because I'm doing it in my living room. I don't have a room right now because we are moving, since we moved back to this house that's really small. From here we're moving, so I can have my own room and stuff again, and I'll be able to do more content then and have my computer. The longer games do take quite a bit longer with this play recorder, because I'm not just doing it all at one time, just, you know, playing through it for a little while. But it's much better that way, because the quality is a lot better all the way around, you know, sound, video, everything. The gameplay I'm showing you guys. It's easier for me to record. My camera wasn't really that high quality. Also, there's this P, and I think it makes you stronger. I don't think you are invincible, but you can take a lot more hits, and I think it even maybe lets you attack more, like your powers more. I'm not really sure if P stands for power or power up or whatever, but most levels are pretty basic, and they're not really that big, but this game is pretty fun. I wouldn't say that you could really just sit here and play this game for a really, really long time. It would get kind of repetitive because of the levels. But after, you know, maybe 30 minutes, an hour, and then you just stop, you know, something like that. Play a few days, and then stop, and then play a few days the next day, you know. Something to pass the time and do. I had originally uploaded a video of me playing Tetris, but I couldn't download it because it failed for some reason. But I did pretty good. I got like 180,000 score on Tetris. And I beat my record, which kind of made me sad because I couldn't upload it, but you guys probably really aren't interested in that too much, and I decided I would put my first game day in my announcement too. Because this game is pretty basic, I don't really even need to talk about the gameplay that much anymore, because it's pretty much the same thing. Sometime I'm going to be doing games more like, you know, how I would do Angry Birds and stuff like that. They're going to be more game day games. These will be anywhere from Monday to Saturday is the week, but not Monday, because Monday's not the first day of the week, obviously, but Sunday to Saturday. I always get that confused. I always think Monday is the first day, not of the week, but I always think of the weekdays because of school. I know the first day of the week is Sunday and the last day is Saturday, but I always think of the first day of actually doing anything for me is Monday. But yeah. See more of these jumping zombies. There might be anywhere from 1 to 3 of these a week, depending on how much I have time. And in between those days, I will be working on getting gameplay and editing my iPod Touch Game of the Weeks, and you'll probably see them more around 2 weeks apiece, to a month, somewhere from 4 to 2 a month. So you see me clear the second day I did, and then I showed just a little clip of fighting this guy. As you can see, he's really hard, and he does attack where he charges at you. I didn't know he had at first. I almost died. And then I realized, oh, it's not really that hard to avoid. You just move out of the way. But, yeah. And when you push the shooting button, it zooms in, but with the chainsaw, it doesn't really. Which is a nice thing. The controls are pretty responsive, but sometimes going through menus and stuff, it likes to go to the next item because it likes to, like, think you're scrolling really fast. Now, I do give this game probably a 3 out of 5. It's a little bit repetitive. The controls are a little bit weird and awkward. You can't really select everything that you want all the time. It lags a tiny bit. There's a little bit of frame rate issues. This, nothing like the video is right now. It was just freaking out for some reason with my display recorder. It never does this when you're not using display recorder. Yeah, I'd say 3 out of 5. It's fun, and it's fun to play for a little while. There are a lot of upgrades in guns you can unlock, so you can probably get really far. There might be other levels, I'm not really sure, but there aren't really that many levels as I can see. So I would say it's a little bit repetitive, and the controls are a little bit messed up, and it's kind of over-responsive sometimes and under-responsive a lot of times. But overall, it's a good, fun game. 3 out of 5.